Hey guys, Roker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career, where last time I left off, I beat Arsenal in the FA Cup and picked up another win in the league. Just continuing the normal flow of events, you know what I mean? Feeling you guys know what I mean. This
our match today
game
as we welcome you to
is
the home
a big
Liverpool
one.
Football Club comes from Anfield.
You know, when you think that facing Crystal Palace, no offense, Crystal Palace, is especially not from a Liverpool fan and concerned, and you're one of the teams we hate playing. But look at that. That's why it's important.
They won away.
Temporarily, Crystal Palace are in second place. He's still the closest team to me. Well, Man City do have that game in hand, so, you know. Crystal Palace are only second
building on the best defense. Well, some people call it
technicality. Because, I mean, unless Man City lose their game in hand.
This is the Liverpool side. Loris Karius is the goalkeeper today. David Alaba starts with Nathaniel Klein as the wide defenders. Dele Alli starts with Renato Sanchez in central.
Considering there's a 7-goal gap, I don't know if I can.
Tremendous form recently.
I'll do my best to rip ball.
Danda starts in goal.
I mean, I gave Crystal Palace a smashing. I think that was in season one.
Not far wide at all. Next time, maybe he'll bury that.
I know I've given them a bit of a bad beating before, so who knows?
We don't need to see all the cards here from the referee, and he's keeping the cards in his pocket. Just a free
kick. We shall see. But, you know, my goal is just to win the game. I don't need to win it by any deserved amount. Goals, I'll score. Whatever is necessary. Whatever.
Crisp defending there.
I get the opportunities and take. It's
a real individual charge here with the ball. He's still going.
For both of us, this is game number 24, which puts us 14 games after this. Of course, Man City will have 16 games.
He's got his shot off now.
Well, I don't think they're playing. The only other games it was thing was allowing me to keep track of were the Arsenal games and Spurs game. So
lost his head there.
And neither of them are playing Manchester City. They're not playing each other. That's why it's two different games. One's playing Stoke and the other's playing can't remember, but it's not Man City. We'll check at halftime. Now maybe Man City are playing in a later game, or I don't know. But if they aren't playing, then after this they will temporarily have two games, which doesn't really bother me because Man City, even with those two games in hand, they'll be still on the same points as Crystal Palace will be after this game, 41.
He hasn't got the technique to bury it from that distance.
No, and he had options left and right as well, so what a poor decision.
I'll have opened the gap to
Divo Origi. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. He can cross it now.
28 at the moment.
Goes for goal with the header.
Three.
Great work by the goalkeeper.
Is all the thing going on? I can't even remember.
Benteke.
I know they're on 41.
A lovely run here.
Coutinho.
Shots on here. An advantage for Lip. Well, it is a free kick. And they're excited.
Hey!
It's a real chance to at least work the goalkeeper.
I like Renato fucking chased after.
Right over the top. Well, he went for the top corner and just got it.
Wasn't the best free kick.
I think the keeper's saw that all the way and he was comfortable.
Yeah, I'm on 68 points. So, yeah, I am 69 points, sorry. 68 would put me on. 71.
So for the home team, the chance for
I think it's possible here, to be on.
But they had to work hard for the away win, and I'm sure the opposition will be determined to stop it being a double over them.
Yeah, funnily enough, it might not be as easy at home as it was away in that reverse game. We'll see.
James Tompkins. Pizarro. Good challenge. Trying to switch on the shot on. Gone for goal in spectacular start.
You guys yourself, you know.
Expecting him to be wheeling away in celebration there.
Nathaniel Clyne.
And he heads it. Mane! There we go. There's the opening goal. The assist from Roberto Firmino. Oh, the header from Mane. Crystal Palace, they were freaking.
The goalkeeper did get a touch.
It took a bit of time, but in the end, it was inevitable.
Harshest critic, this lad, and he'll blame himself for that, I think, having got a touch.
Yeah, get him. Goal number 15 for the season, for this season. From Sadio Mane.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. Pizarro.
Young. And has put me on course to win this game. And
James McArthur.
Who 31 points ahead.
4 minutes. That's what we've got about
of Crystal Palace and Man City until they play. Hey. Even after if they are unsuccessful, you can only hope.
That's half time.
They're not playing today.
By the referee, 1-0 the half time.
Then they must be playing a different day. No, that
defense. I think they'll feel, although it's a tightish game, they can see it through here.
Great cross, Roberto.
Defensive record. Who would bet against them not winning this match?
Too happy ones. Well, he was like. I could have done that earlier in the game. Oh, Man City are playing. They're just not on at the same time. Southampton and Swansea. Why did I think I saw Stoke? I mean, I was kind of... Alright, that they start with S. Arsenal are losing to Southampton and Spurs are nil all with Swansea. City are playing Leicester. Okay then. Substitution for Chris going into that, and when they kick off, they will be 31 points behind. 41. I'm adding 10 points to myself.
Saw it coming, cut it out, good work. Good position.
Well,
this attack very well. In with the chops.
Hey, especially he went. And they get a bit of luck like that. Divo Origi. Straight from the kickoff. A bit of luck, but you know they all count.
It was a pretty good effort to.
Somehow.
Well beaten, really.
Yeah, I don't think you can blame the keeper, Martin. He's looking at the defenders. Why was the lad given so much space?
Probably didn't go now. It kind of looks like it should have been an own goal, if I'm being brutally honest. But hey, that's 2-0. And yeah, that's put me in a very good position to see off Crystal Palace. And
good this move. Slipped his man.
Extend my lead at the top of the league even further. Even if it is only temporary, depending on what Man City do against Leicester.
Now they've got to try and regain possession.
Of course, I have the technical fact that they do still have a game in hand. Besides,
that's a penalty.
Oh, a penalty! Scott. And man. Hey.
Well, it's a penalty, and the referees added to their problems.
Yeah, lost the composure.
Roberto Firmino once again gets.
Get worse here.
All up in Crystal Palace's business, and Scott Dan did not deal with him the best of his ability.
Great penalty.
David Alaba once again scores from the spot, still with only one miss from the spot as a Liverpool player. Mandanda didn't even bother. He was like, this match is over anyway.
Given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0.
Only Alaba's second season? He's not been.
It's Ward.
Yeah. Strapped for penalties this season. I was getting a good few of them last season. They're which on is the where now. Most of Alaba's goals came from last season. He got only like strong two in open play.
Out for a throw, though.
The rest were all Ward penalties.
Throw. Straight to the opposition. Palace about to make a change here.
Renato Sanchez.
Some potential in this move. Tackle goes in. And that will be Liverpool's throw in.
He's about to take the shot.
Roberto Firmino. Oh, well.
Oof.
Such a good cross up.
That was meant to be a cross. It almost dipped in.
Sadio Mane had scouts from all the big clubs looking at him. He got his move that he wanted, really, to a step up, he felt, to Liverpool.
He's got that ability to find space within shooting distance, and he's done it really well today, and found the back of the net too. He's one of the best, Martin, at just shifting across, reading the
Dele
on the
Sadio Mane.
This is how they love to play on the break. Gone on one possession back with that tackle.
No ideal. Okay, Alaba will retrieve it. Oh, that's a filthy foul from Zaha. Yellow card, that man.
Yeah, I don't think there's any choice there from the ref.
I guess he felt he had to intervene in some way. Again, that almost bounced in. I was trying to put it on a plate for someone, but no one at the... And then there's like, thank you very much, I'll take that.
Could be dangerous. Defender to it, and shoots!
Hey! Crystal Palace's first shot of the game isn't even on target. Wait, is that their first shot of the game?
This could be it.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Especially not when Origi makes it 4-0. And that is that. No question.
Went into the
it is game over.
He took it with great aplomb. I'm sure getting the first goal gave him the confidence to grab the second chance.
I mean,
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
Put my best effort in to really damage that 7-goal gap between Man City and Crystal Palace. I have effectively completely chopped off one of its legs, which is 4-0 win.
For more at 4-0.
And there's time to add more, which Man City would be very pleased about. I mean, if they're not going to get first, then I'm sure they would
Joel Ward.
Like to... Nab second. As it looks like the
coming up for you on EA Sports.
Run is about to end. Finally, get end.
We'll be facing Stoke City away from home.
Yeah, really looking forward to this.
In case you're new and you absolutely know,
we've got 8 more minutes.
Chelsea have a habit of coming second to me.
4-0 here. When they do almost time up. What does this mean for their next game?
Remember, I believe, like, majority of the time, like 90% of the time, it's going to be Chelsea in second place.
It has been.
Like, it's rare that anyone else finishes in second, but Chelsea.
And we've known who's going to win for a long time now. It has been very one-sided.
We could be in. Shots on here.
Have not really put their best foot forward this season.
The team is lining up.
Costing them. Of course, they still have time. And they're not a million miles off it.
Round of applause for today's man of the match. Number 11, Roberto Firmino.
And if they go in, of course.
That was too high.
Wow, what a great decision. If they don't.
Not good enough, Deli. Not good enough.
And I don't think this player is the sort capable of finding the back of the net from the distance.
4 minutes. Irrelevant.
He has chosen to add on.
I would actually be pissed if it were 0-0.
Good forward play from them.
But 4-0, I'll let it slide.
Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. The final whistle from the
referee. And there's the full time whistle.
Well, look at that score.
Oh, dominating 4-0. Oh, Victor. He 2 goals from Divo Origi. He Sadio Mane. He getting on the score sheet as well. And the penalty. He as well. Because why the hell not? Arsenal dropped 2 points. 1-1 draw with Southampton. Spurs
Everton
did beat
2, Chelsea 0. Hull City 1.
Now we'll
Aston
see.
Villa,
Man
1.
City won their game, Liverpool, which means 4. They are
Crystal Palace 0.
Up in to second
City,
place,
2.
And Crystal Palace
City,
is loss has severely crippled
Arsenal,
their
1.
Their positioning.
0.
They've fallen.
West Ham United 2.
Just above Chelsea
Swansea City 0.
You can see
Tottenham Hotspur
where they
1.
Are currently.
West Bromwich Albion
0.
Manchester United 2.
In case you just found us.
So what do those results mean
are?
To the league table? At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 72 points. In second, rising up the table, are Manchester City with 44 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In third, climbing the table, are Tottenham Hotspur with 43 points. In fourth, rising up the table, are Manchester United with 43 points, but only behind on goal difference. In fifth,
we're almost at 85. He'd be far better if you were 85.
In sixth,
although he's not a bad player.
With 38 points. In seventh, climbing
the table, really
Everton
to,
with 36 points.
Going up to
in eighth,
79.
West Bromwich Albion with 35 points.
Fayor's about halfway, might as well leave him in there until he goes.
Bottom
up.
Of the table, Derby County with 12 points.
Oh, wow.
Game in hand on the team above.
Three players went up. And
second bottom,
that's
Southampton with 20 points, but only behind
Daniel
on goal difference. Third bottom, Hull City with 20 points. Fourth bottom, moving down, Swansea City with 22 points. Fifth bottom, falling, are Middlesbrough with 23 points, with a game in hand on the team above.
Davis has indeed gone up to 75 rated. Wonderful. Freeze those spots for the next training session. That's not of importance right now. Ooh. What is of importance is, oh, maybe that's why I was thinking of Stoke City, because they're my second game of the episode. Fair enough. Since this is going up on St. Patrick's Day, hey, I'll put us in the green. Okay, why not? Chelsea, Man City, and I don't need to follow the Leicester game. The Chelsea and Man City games, I'll keep a close eye on those.
Should have a fine game for you today. Welcome to it. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith.
So is the Britannia the Britannia anymore? Is it
season when Chelsea
not
really
called
did
that?
It's going along the same lines again.
Well,
hey, Stoke City fans,
I can't believe.
And feel free to let me know, because I'm
stage in the season, and I just don't think they're going to recover.
If that is the case, I didn't hear that. I was really confused.
Stoke City team, here it is for you, Mark Muniesa with Ryan
Shawcross in from the Gillette Sock for Saturday.
With Jordan Henderson in midfield, and just one attacker in the lineup.
Bet 365 stadium.
This is the Liverpool side.
Same as that.
Is the goalkeeper today?
I was so confused. I was. And I saw. That's the protagonist.
Center of the park in attack. Divo Origi starts. He's been in tremendous form recently.
And I think potential in this move. Britannia is the first thing that comes into my head.
At full extension, the goalkeeper makes the save.
Okay.
Corner now for Liverpool.
Right. I'm not gonna lie. I really thought that was gonna go in. Good save from the Stoke keeper. Made that not the case. Corner again.
And here's the shot.
Dele Alli! Oh, what a goal!
Most things he does, he's got an air of grace about him.
He went for it. And since it's the day for it, he had the luck of the Irish on his side. What a hell not.
It's a good one.
Well, here's the goal again.
I mean, he is wearing number 7. That's supposed to be a lucky number. What a goal. That makes up for the Coutinho shot being saved. What a goal, Dele. What a goal.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
This is a fourth goal.
Muniesa.
Assigned to Mendy.
They're going to have to restart with a throw.
He now has double the amount of goals this season.
He made the interception.
For Liverpool, then he does. Then he did hit it. Well,
an update
the time up until I signed him that he played for Spurs. Manchester City. It's been scored by Mauro Icardi. It was a good few games. Magical run beating three defenders. That's not good enough. 16 minutes played, 1-0. 1-0 down to Man City. Didn't see anything pop up for Chelsea, but there could have been an update as I was scoring. So maybe I might miss something.
Came in with the challenge and the ball broke free.
They were too focused on what I was doing.
Got past his man here.
Oh, come on, Divock. Stronger ahead on that.
Philipp Wolscheid. Well, it is an occupational hazard, particularly for defenders. The first-choice centre-back is suspended today.
Yeah, he makes his fair share of tackles.
Renato Sanchez.
He'll have to do the same. He'll have to be dominant and confident.
Roberto Firmino.
Chance. And here comes the counter-attack.
Power to the middle, 2-0. Get in, Bobby, you fucking beast.
They've worked very hard for this.
He's a good... assisted in the opener against Crystal Palace. Won the penalty. That made it 3-0 against Crystal Palace. And scores the second goal. Both a double for the league here against Stoke. Good episode for Roberto from... Well, the man has not lost his touch from his injury earlier in the season. Noticing a trend here. It's Roberto Firmino's fourth goal this season as well. While Dele Alli has 6 overall because of his 2 at Spurs. His fourth for Liverpool.
Glenn Johnson. He just loves attacking.
Of course,
this fella.
Roberto Firmino has scored
more. He finds extra energy for it.
4 goals.
Yeah, I think he used to.
He might be
his whole time at the club. But he scored 4.
Very good challenge. Probing away. Trying to find room for a shot, maybe. Good forward play from them. Made the challenge well. Shots on here. That's a good
find the block is there and spotted that deflection.
He's pointing to the corner.
Chiefs were winning the corner there, Nathaniel.
shot.
Good work by the goalkeeper.
The sting was really taken out of the shot by Phil with the block from the Stoke player. Getting in the way of
it. They might open them up now. A real chance.
Origi. It's not his fourth of the season. It's his 33rd of the season. If
fantastic goal.
Oh, how quickly did they go back to front there? What a counter attack!
Well, it's a goal worth replaying over and over again, isn't it?
I think it's safe to say Divock Origi will be the top goal scorer for this season. It is indeed his 33rd of the season in the Premier League. Should specify.
And Liverpool putting on
I think he has a few goals from his time in the second team before he got promoted to the first team
for Stoke City.
The opposition goalkeeper, he might as well read the paper and get a chair out because he's just not been worked.
It's a good run from Glenn Johnson. Good play, but they've lost the ball now, and the opposition can get at them. Strong challenge. There will be a minimum and the decision for the added
time. Nathaniel Klein puts it on a play for Ori. Works his way into the space. Oh!
Made a good contribution to it. It could have been a massive
goal. Goal number 34 goes.
He just took his eye off the ball. Thought the chance was a little too
gaping.
He's on a high after scoring already, but let himself down there.
He didn't even hit the woodwork to have it end up coming back into play, and there's the halftime. And whistle as if to say, and the referee's like, yeah, I think you guys need to assess what happened there. Chelsea are winning against Southampton. So far, two of the three teams around me who are playing today are winning. Crystal Palace haven't kicked off yet, but luckily I'm winning, so I'm
really
still.
Was a very one-sided first half, and
the. I still haven't dropped any points in the Premier League.
Has got to show a bit of backbone.
I mean, that's just bonkers.
That could be a goal kick. Alan, what's gone wrong with him? He looks off the pace.
Well, with his team losing, they will want to get the ball into him much more than they have so far.
Undefeated in season one. Undefeated in season two. Surely not. Three consecutive undefeated Premier League seasons.
Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well.
Surely
he's certainly been an influence on this first half.
I would be happy with that first 45 minutes. It was a good goal from him. Good overall performance.
Brave man to bet against it.
He's coming forward.
I wouldn't recommend it.
Some danger.
Nathaniel Klein. Oh, that would have been unbelievable.
What we've got on EA Sports very soon for you, the presentation of the FA Cup.
I would have actually rather if that had gone in for the own goal, because it would have been so hilarious. Because it was Nathaniel Klein almost setting up an own goal for Glenn Johnson, who Nathaniel Klein replaced. No bones about it, he replaced a really shit right back. Nathaniel Klein.
Goalkeeper, good technique. Liverpool's
he's okay. Yeah. His form dips every now and again.
Now they're playing Wolfsburg in the next match in the Champions Cup.
Still,
I can see only one winner. I think they'll find
one of the best right backs in the Premier League.
Attacking well here.
It'd be hard.
Attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance.
Argue. Well, with not one of the top the five.
Half an hour to go.
I mean, the top is probably Kyle Walker, if I'm being brutally honest. I mean, you can make an argument for Hector Bellerin when he's playing good, but, you know, he's also off form, so.
This could be a chance.
Oh, fucker.
And here's the shot.
Loving life. Someone else who's loving life is virtual Divock Origi, because he has 34 goals for the season. I have four.
Four.
I think Stoke are gonna hate the number four for a while. I just get the feeling because fours are popping up everywhere. Four for Ali. Four for Firmino. Four goals overall. 34 for Herbie Fucker.
They converted
right, that not all of them have been made the score Stoke. Otherwise, the attacking third.
Gets his foot in there. And he's presented the ball to the opposition.
Coming to its merciful end.
Still 20 minutes to go. Intercepted well.
Cakewalk.
It's a terrible place to give the ball away. Sherdan Shaqiri. Coutinho.
Brace in a 4-0 victory.
Do that.
If it stays at 4-0, of course.
From the Etihad, from Ala McAnally.
It's a second goal for Manchester City. 75 minutes played. 2-0.
Mon Mills for from
Ala McAnally. Thanks, Alan.
3 points from Man City, probably. Attack. 2-0. It was going to be a
short passes, but they're keeping the ball.
Hard gap to overcome for Middlesbrough now. Very little time to
interception.
Barely enough time to salvage a point, let alone pick up.
They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width
into
this attack.
They will pick up all three. A draw would probably be my best hope, and you know, I'm not gonna hold my breath for that.
So not much time left at all. What does this mean, Alan, for their next game?
Yeah, Stoke City go up against Aston Villa, Martin, and
Chelsea. Maybe I'll get good news from the Chelsea game. Although they're further away, I would rather Man City drop a
Martin has been totally dominant.
Chelsea.
And, as a result, well, he's.
I mean, I won't mind Chelsea dropping points. The more rivals of mine drop points, the better. But,
and he could get away here.
Origi can't finish the hat trick. Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Well, they're getting set.
Unbelievable. Cool.
Matip! Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his and he's made sure he's protected it. Hearing there will be three added minutes here.
3 minutes added time.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Be over. There we go.
And that's the final.
I was gonna say it would be over any second, and the referee's like, "Oh yeah," as if me about to say that reminded him. There was a second goal in the Chelsea game, unfortunately, it went to Chelsea.
Aston Villa 1.
So Everton, both of them won 2-0.
Chelsea
2. I'm sure
Southampton
fills
nil.
Crystal Palace with
Crystal
delight.
Palace 4. Hull City 1.
City
1. Derby County 1. Manchester City 2. Middlesbrough 0. Stoke City 0. Liverpool 4. Now let's see what effect that's had on the league standings. At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 75 points. In second, Manchester City with 47 points.
Every time I look, someone else is close.
The team above. In third, rising up the table are Crystal Palace with 44 points. In fourth, moving down, are Tottenham Hotspur with 43 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In fifth and falling are Manchester United with 43 points, but only behind on goal difference. In sixth, Chelsea with 41 points.
Random.
In seventh, Everton with 37 points. In eighth, West Bromwich Albion with 35 points, with a game
overall,
in hand on the team above. Bottom of the table, Derby County with 14 points, with a game in hand on the team above. Second bottom, Southampton with 20 points, but only behind on goal difference. Third bottom, Hull City with 20 points. Fourth bottom, Swansea City with 22 points, with a game in hand.
The war and Rico Henry
fifth
will
bottom,
probably
Middlesbrough
go up in the
with
next
23
train
points.
Session. But I have to wait till the next episode probably. In the next episode would a nice trip to Germany is in order for my hey first leg of the last 16 against Wolfsburg in the Champions League. So, don't miss that episode. But it will be up on Monday. Until, that episode. Well, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.